WFYI Podcasts, brought to you by Bloomington, home to the Indiana Hoosiers and over 200,000 acres of fall foliage in the Hoosier National Forest. Indulge in seasonal flavors at the Elm, experience breathtaking views atop four fire towers, or catch a Big Ten football game at Memorial Stadium. More, including how to plan your fall getaway, at visitbloomington.com.
I'm Kyle Long, producer of Echoes of Indiana Avenue and Cultural Manifesto. Before we join Echoes of Indiana Avenue, I'd like to remind you that we're in the middle of our fall membership drive here at WFYI. And this year, we have a special thank you gift for listeners who support this station. A limited edition 45 RPM single featuring a lost recording by the legendary Indianapolis R&B group, The Vanguards. You can get a copy of this rare disc when you become a member of this station at WFYI.org/give. It's listeners like you that make local programs like Cultural Manifesto and Echoes of Indiana Avenue possible. And it was your support that led to the discovery of this lost Vanguards recording. I'm going to share that song on this week's show, but first, I want to give you a bit of the backstory behind this recording. The Vanguards were signed to the Indianapolis label Lamp Records. Lamp has been called Naptown's Motown. It was a black-owned company that issued funk and soul recordings from local bands. The label was founded in 1969 by a young Indianapolis firefighter named Herb Miller. The Vanguards were the first group Miller signed to the label, and their debut single, Somebody Please, was a national hit. And over the years, Somebody Please has become an enduring classic of R&B music. During my time at WFYI, I've extensively researched the history of Herb Miller, Lamp Records, and the Vanguards. And while doing that research, I uncovered this lost demo recording from the Vanguards. I recently had an opportunity to discuss this recording with Lamp's founder, Herb Miller. And he told me he knew the Vanguards were special the first time he saw them perform.
I saw them, I loved the music, and figured this will be our starting point. If I can get them, then we can move forward.
Somebody Please was written by the Vanguards' lead vocalist, James Davis.
James and I were friends from the beginning. James, of course, you know, was phenomenal. He was a great personality, and the Vanguards as a group were easy to work with. Somebody please.
In 2017, I spoke with Davis, and he recalled the group's journey to success.
We were doing shows with Isaac Hayes, everybody. So I said, well, I believe we're going to make it, you know.
Davis also recalled the enthusiastic response the Vanguards were getting from audiences around the country.
I remember crying to her because they were ripping off my ruffles off shirt and stuff. I was trying to apologize to her. Herb said, no, let him take it. Let him take it. Herb, I'll get you another shirt.
But the Vanguards' time together would be short-lived. In the mid-1970s, Miller walked away from Lamp Records. The Vanguards split apart soon after, but Davis and Miller maintained their friendship.
James and I remained friends. I was with James the day before he passed. Our relationship was from beginning to end. You know, it's like losing a family member when he passed away.
James Davis was the last surviving member of the Vanguards, and when he died in 2019, most fans assumed that would be the end of the Vanguards' story, but it wasn't.
I was raised in a one-room shack in the ghetto. Ghetto! And my dreams to leave this old shack by the railroad.
In my work with WFYI, I've uncovered hundreds of endangered recordings of historically important Indiana music. And in 2023, I came across an unreleased demo recording from the Vanguards. Earlier this year, I had a chance to play the song for Miller.
I love the music. Man, I've been bouncing off the sidewalk since then.
Miller is currently retired. He'll turn 85 this year, and it's been over 50 years since he shut down Lamp Records. But after hearing the song, he decided to relaunch the label with a limited edition release of the track.
Tell me about how that feels, starting this label back up again all these years later.
I feel like I'm 21, okay? It was just invigorating. I've never been happier than this for a long time.
I'm just curious how you perceive WFYI's role in helping to preserve Lamp Records. Because we don't have the constraints of commercial media, we can cover things in more depth.
This is the place you need to be, and this is who you need to tune in to, because you need to deal with the people that support you. Where else would you go to get the community support? No place are you going to go to get the support that you can get from WFYI.
That was The Vanguards with Ghetto. And you can receive a limited edition 45 RPM recording of that song as a thank you gift when you support this station at wfyi.org/give.
What we're going to do right here is go back, way back, back into time.
This is Butch Slaughter, and you're listening to the Echoes of Indiana Avenue. Welcome to my neighborhood, The Avenue. I grew up here, and each week I'll be sharing the sounds and stories of the people that made The Avenue great. Welcome back to The Avenue. On this week's show, we'll explore the music of Naptown trumpet player Michael Ridley. Michael performed with some of the greatest stars in American music, including Stevie Wonder, James Brown, Wilson Pickett, and Otis Redding. But he's best known for his work in jazz. Michael worked with many jazz greats, from Archie Shepp to Jimmy McGriff. For the next hour, we'll take a deep dive into the music of Michael Ridley. Michael Ridley was born in Indianapolis in 1939. At that time, his family lived in Lockefield Gardens, a federal housing project located on the avenue. The family later moved to the Highland Vicinity neighborhood, and Michael attended Shortridge High School. He performed with the school band and studied music at the Ruth MacArthur Conservatory on Indiana Avenue. There was music in Michael's home, too. His older brother, Larry Ridley, is a legendary jazz bassist known for his work with Thelonius Monk, Freddie Hubbard, Chet Baker, and others. By the 1960s, Michael had left Naptown, eventually joining his brother Larry in New York. One of the first records Michael cut in New York was a single released by the Indianapolis sax player James Spalding. That record also featured Larry Ridley on bass. We'll hear both sides of that single now. From 1971, this is James Spalding with Uhura Sasa and Give It Up. That was James Spalding with Give It Up, featuring the Naptown trumpet player Michael Ridley. In 1972, Michael was featured on the album Attica Blues, a landmark recording by the free jazz saxophonist Archie Shepp. The album explored themes of social justice and racial equality. Up next, we'll listen to a pair of tracks from Attica Blues, featuring Michael Ridley on trumpet. This is Archie Shepp with Blues for Brother George Jackson and Goodbye, Sweet Pops. That was Archie Shepp with Goodbye, Sweet Pops, featuring the Naptown trumpet player Michael Ridley. On this week's show, we're exploring the music of Michael Ridley. Up next, we'll hear a track from a 1984 session Michael cut with the soul jazz organist Jimmy McGriff. From the album Skywalk, this is Easy Time. That was Jimmy McGriff with Easy Time, featuring the Naptown trumpet player Michael Ridley. Echoes of Indiana Avenue will return with more music from Michael Ridley after this short break.
WFYI Podcasts, brought to you by Bloomington, home to the Indiana Hoosiers and over 200,000 acres of fall foliage in the Hoosier National Forest. Indulge in seasonal flavors at the Elm, experience breathtaking views atop four fire towers, or catch a Big Ten football game at Memorial Stadium. More, including how to plan your fall getaway, at visitbloomington.com.
This is Butch Slaughter, and you're listening to the Echoes of Indiana Avenue. On this week's show, we're exploring the music of Michael Ridley, an Indianapolis trumpet player known for his work in jazz music. Michael was the younger brother of the legendary Naptown jazz bassist Larry Ridley. In 1975, Michael was featured on an album by Clifford Thornton and the Jazz Composers Orchestra titled The Gardens of Harlem. That record featured a unique blend of jazz music with West African and Afro-Caribbean rhythms. Up next, we'll hear a track from that album featuring a trumpet solo from Michael Ridley. This is Clifford Thornton and the Jazz Composers Orchestra with Agbaza. That was Clifford Thornton and the Jazz Composers Orchestra with Agbaza, featuring the Naptown trumpet player Michael Ridley. We'll end this week's show with two tracks Michael recorded with the Brooklyn Repertory Ensemble in 2002. From the album Passport to Brooklyn, this is Moonlight in Vermont and Malik. Was the Brooklyn Repertory Ensemble with Malik, featuring the Naptown trumpet player Michael Ridley. Michael Ridley died in May of 2011. He was 72 years old. Thanks for tuning in for this exploration of the music of Michael Ridley. You can meet me here on the Avenue again next week, same time, same place. You can find the Echoes of Indiana Avenue podcast on Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, or wherever you download your podcasts. Echoes of Indiana Avenue is written and produced by Kyle Long and hosted and co-produced by me, Herman Butch Slaughter.
Nobody knows on Uptown, baby, like I do, do. Nobody knows on Uptown, baby, like I do, do. If you will stop and listen, I will tell you a thing or two.
WFYI Podcasts, brought to you by Bloomington, home to the Indiana Hoosiers and over 200,000 acres of fall foliage in the Hoosier National Forest. Indulge in seasonal flavors at the Elm, experience breathtaking views atop four fire towers, or catch a Big Ten football game at Memorial Stadium. More, including how to plan your fall getaway, at visitbloomington.com.